Herkese merhaba.
Merhaba.
Video İngilizce olacak. Altyazılarınızı açmayı unutmayın. Bugün Japonların iş bulma süreci hakkında konuşacağız. Hi Kimi.
Hey.
Can you introduce yourself to us?
Hello everyone. I'm Kimi. I'm a college student in Japan. I'm majoring in international relations and minoring in Japanese language education. I've shown up in some of her YouTube videos before, but this is officially the first time, so I'm very excited. Nice to meet you all. And today I'm very excited to let you know about one of the unique Japanese culture, job hunting. Yay.
よろしくお
よろ
願
し
い
くお
し
願いし
ます。
ます。So let me explain a basic rule of job hunting in Japan. I have experienced studying abroad. I studied political science and Spanish in California for 1 year, so I kind of know how job hunting works in the United States. And then there are two major differences between in Japan and then in the United States. First, in the United States, st college students start to look for a job after they graduate from university. First, college students in Japan have to find a job before they graduate from university. And secondly, Japanese companies adopt lifelong employment system, so they recruit fresh graduates altogether. In short, it's a one-time opportunity. And then both companies and students want an exact match for everyone's sake, right? And then that's why in Japan, both companies and students spend so much time on finding one single job. So this is basically how job hunting starts and ends. As I said before, college students in the United States start to look for a job after they graduate from university, but in Japan, it's not the case. So first, in the summer of their junior year, like third grade, we experience internships and try to get to know about the job in Japan. In winter, students have to do self-analysis. It's like we try to understand ourselves, looking back our experiences, and from them, what have I learned, have we learned. Also, we meet graduates, also known as senpai in Japanese, right? And after that, in spring, we start to look for a job very, very seriously. Like we go to company seminars or taking interviews, taking tests, etc. And then by summer, most students decide which company to work with, and right after they graduate from university, they start to work. So this is the basic step for getting a job offer from one company. First, we students go to company seminar to get information about the company and the recruiting. Second, we finally and officially apply to companies by submitting resumes. And after that, students have to take aptitude tests.
It's kind of like a general information test, like math, Japanese, English too.
Yeah, English too. Yeah.
But not specific major, like not your major,
Yeah,
general. Everyone takes the same
everyone
exam.
takes the same test. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So after that, finally, we can meet the employees of the companies.
The first interview?
First interview is a group. Like there are like four or five students and then two or three employees, and then group interviews. And after that, the second interview was human resource members, which is 101 or 102, small number. And the third interview is also an individual, and but this is with executive board members. So like it's a really serious thing, final steps.
You know? So someone from your major now, right?
No.
No? You don't do interview with someone in your major?
It depends on your major. If students are science major, it's more related to their majors.
Okay.
But we like social science or humanities are not like that. So, and then after a few more steps, we finally get an official offer from one company. So for each company, we have like 6, 7, or 10 steps to get the job offer, but we have to apply for several companies. Most students apply for like 10 or 15 companies.
Wow.
Yeah.
So much.
Yeah. And among those 10 or 15 companies, we can get 2 or 3 job offers to pick. It's really tough. Yeah, it's really harsh, right? So that's the basic information about how job hunting works in Japan.
So I want to ask you some questions.
Okay.
I heard that some companies choose some students from specific universities.
Yeah.
Is it common?
Yeah, it is. Basically, big, huge companies do that. They have some numbers of open seats for students from specific universities, of like the leading universities. But for students of university like ours, it's not common. We don't have that much like open seats. Make sense?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, so Japanese companies or Japanese people tend to judge people just from the university they went, they go. So that's why it happens. Yeah.
Okay, important question.
Okay.
What is the dress code in Japan for job hunting? It's so serious.
Yeah.
And I want you to explain it.
So we have very strict dress code for women. We have to always tie our hair like this. And then we have to wear simple makeup. No earrings, no accessories.
Really?
At all.
I didn't know it.
No, and then we can't wear nails like this. And for like dress code, we have to wear a very simple, plain black and a white suit. The picture should be around somewhere around here. Yeah. So we cannot wear navy suits. We cannot wear gray suits. We have to wear just black suits, both for women and for men.
For women, does it make difference to wear skirts or pants? Both okay?
Oh, both okay. Both okay.
Depending on what you want.
Depending on what you want, but yeah. Mostly I preferred pants.
Yeah, more comfortable.
But majority of students, majority of ladies wear skirts.
What about shoes?
Shoes have to be black.
Heels?
Heels, like 3-5 centimeter, like this. Yeah.
You cannot wear normal, like flat shoes.
Never, ever.
Oh, really?
It's very strict. And it's very annoying. Because we cannot express anything about ourselves.
Yeah, exactly. Everyone's equal.
Yeah, everyone's equal.
It's kind of good, but too strict.
Yeah, kind of. And I'm not sure, but I think companies try to judge or evaluate students if they can be true to the rules. Like, they can follow the rules.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And
also, the hair should be like this.
Yeah.
But can you do like
Bun? What was the word?
Yeah, you can do that.
Is
yeah,
this tech. Okay?
Yeah, it works.
Both
it's okay. Both okay. Yeah.
Just hair must be tied.
Must be tied.
Mm.
And then can show your face very clearly.
Okay, for the dress code, I want to mention this, like, everyone dressed the same.
Yeah.
Even the coat is the same. Even the bag mm-hmm. is the same. Mm-hmm. So on the street, when you see people, you can understand it's jumper
thing. Oh, yeah. Definitely.
It's so funny. Like, everyone's dressing the same. And sometimes I see, like, let's say, 3 girls together going somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Do you do it, like, with your friends?
Yeah, probably. Yeah, some girls or boys go to the interviews or seminars of the same company together, but sometimes we can make friends.
Oh, right, because you're going to same interview a few times.
Uh-huh. Internships, company seminars, and interviews like that. And I saw you before, right? And then become friends like that.
So cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but it's actually very weird that on the train, if there are some students doing job hunting, we can instantly know
clothes, give it away.
Clothes and and we are like, oh, good luck, like that.
So even after they finish job hunting, do you have to follow the dress code?
It depends on the company. Some companies ask students to wear the same suits when they get in the company.
Mm-hmm.
So like for entering ceremony, everyone wears the same black suits.
Oh, like right. Anna's picture in the news.
Mm-hmm.
I saw that. It was kind of like scary for me because it kind of reminds me, you know, there are some sci-fi movies and there are robots.
Oh,
dressed in the line.
Yeah.
It reminds me of all the time.
Okay.
It's kind of scary.
Yeah.
Doesn't it? Like everyone's the exact same clothes. Everyone's black hair.
Black hair, no black suits, no color.
Yeah, it's so strict.
Uh-huh.
No, so surprising.
Yeah, for my company I'm gonna work with from next spring, actually doesn't like black suits.
Oh.
So we have to wear bright color.
Oh, okay.
More like white. It could be navy.
Mm.
It could be gray.
Do you allowed to wear jeans?
No way! No way! Are you kidding?
You know, in Turkey, most people, if you're not in sales department, they don't even wear like those pants. We always wear jeans, skirts.
Oh, but it depends on the company and it depends on the department. Like after you start working, right? Like for entering ceremony, we always have to wear suits.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, but for normal like work days, in some companies, yeah, people can wear jeans and
but
shirts.
It's not the common.
But my sister is actually, yeah.
She's allowed to?
Uh-huh.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, she's allowed to wear whatever. Unless you she shows
so much skin. Yeah, that's in Turkey too. Like, you shouldn't wear something short. But in Turkey, for us, when you don't wear jeans, like you wear something serious, they say like, oh, are you going to like job hunting? Kind of like that. Are you going to see some company?
Really?
Yeah, seriously. Even when I was like part-timer, sometimes I wear like those pants and they were saying like, ooh, are you doing like seeing companies? Why are you dressing so serious? Because for us, jeans is normal. You don't need to wear it. It's kind of like too much.
Oh, yeah. Really?
Yeah. So different.
I'm glad that I don't have to do that dressing code either.
Oh, I know. My sister says the exact same thing.
Yeah, right.
So. Because the other day I have to go shopping. I had to go shopping for finding my own suits for ceremony or for working.
Yeah.
And then my sister was like, yeah, I was so lucky that I didn't have to wear suits every day. And I was like, okay, but I have to, you know, so stop talking about it.
So what about the attitudes in general?
So you mean attitudes during the interview? Okay, so we have to be careful about our way of talking. For example, when we enter into the interview room, we have to say よろしくお願いいたします。失礼いたします。
It kind of means like nice to meet you.
よろしくお願いいたします is kind of like thank you for having taking time for us. Like that. 失礼します is like excuse me. And we also have to be very careful about our postures. Like we can't be like this or that, like, you know, cross our legs.
I always sit like this, like my shoulders a bit down.
Oh yeah, that's not good. Yeah, we like always have to be like this. And then hands are like this. Girls.
Like kimono.
Oh yeah, but yeah, we put our hands on the knees, and boys have to maybe like this.
Straight,
yeah. Anyways, like we have to be very like, we have to look like professionals. If it does make sense.
So like when you in the interview, you can't move with your fingers.
No, you can't.
Because in Turkey, when we do interviews, hands usually below the table, so we don't see it.
Oh, so sometimes we don't even have tables.
Yeah, yeah.
So we can't hide our hands and then legs.
Yeah, that's the problem.
That's the problem.
There's no escape.
No escape. No hiding. Yeah.
So funny.
And then yeah, so all the time we have to be like this, smile a little bit.
Right.
Yes. Otherwise, employees of the companies would see us as like arrogant person, lazy person, or unprofessional person like that. So yeah, that's why we have to be very careful about our attitudes during the interview. Yeah.
One more question just came into my mind.
Okay.
No, it's okay. some people, I heard there are some manner classes.
Yes,
we do have. Because of this, like to prepare this. Do you take it as a class in school?
Some schools do have those kind of seminars to learn about basic dress codes, attitudes, the way of talking, how to make resumes like that. Yeah, we do.
It's serious then.
It is. It is. And then actually there are some or many companies that help students to look for and find a job. Some companies or like not related to the companies that students want to work with the third companies.
So,
and then they assist, they support students, and so that students can find a job. Because, you know, students are so desperate and then very competitive, you know, job hunting in Japan is. So some professional people have to support students.
Get it. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
In Japan, job hunting is job hunting. Struggling and competitive.
Yeah, definitely. Because it's very stressful. And for me, I could finish my job hunting in just a few months. just a couple of months, but some students have to spend like 6 months, 7 months to find just a single job. So if some students get rejected or declined by companies they wanted to go, it's very stressful, right? So some students become kind of like depression. So it's very struggling, and yeah, it's very competitive, definitely, because yeah, students want to go to or work for big companies or popular companies, right?
Yeah.
And then those companies are very popular among students too. Yeah. So like it's really hard to get in.
And finally, I want to ask this. Are there some students who cannot find job in the end? Like, is it a huge problem in Japan?
Yeah, there are a few students that cannot find a job eventually. But most of the students can find a job. At least one. So it's not a huge problem in Japan, but yeah, but this year, because of COVID-19, under this situation, companies are also struggling financially. So the number of students the companies are hiring is decreasing, actually. Even for my company, they used to hire 100 students simultaneously.
Really?
100 wow. students, but this year only 40.
That 40 much?
40 students are, you know, going to work together. So it's definitely decreasing. So those students who start the job hunting late, like in May or April, they are very much struggling to find a job. So it could be a huge problem, like under this situation, but normally it's not. Most students can find a job eventually. Yeah.
Okay, so that was it for this week. This is how job hunting works in Japan. So if you have any questions, you can ask it in the comments. We'll try to answer them. Thank you, Kimmy, for answering the questions.
You're welcome.
So see you next week. Arigatou gozaimasu, Kimmy.
Doitashimashite. Kochira koso arigatou gozaimasu.
Bye.
Bye.
Sayonara.
Sayonara. Okay.
Perfect. Yes, perfect.
You YouTuber now.
ちょっと待って、いやー難しいな、説明するの。
あれ変だ。あ、待って、I messed up!
English? Then さよなら。